realestateinvestor.com presents Investing Tips, Picking the Right Contractor by Colin Egbert with Hope Hammond. One of the biggest concerns in house flipping is finding yourself a reliable and competent contractor for those remodeling jobs. Yet many new and even seasoned investors neglect these house flipping basics before jumping into the real estate business. Lack of planning can lead to a loss of income or profits in the case of real estate wholesaling. You can save yourself a lot of hassle, money, and time by following these basic ideas to finding yourself a great contractor for those real estate jobs. When you first start getting offers, don't take the lowball offer. Don't automatically pick the contractor with the lowest offer. If most of your estimates fall within a close range and there's one contractor who's offering a drastically reduced price, you've got to assume there's a reason. He or she isn't just offering a great price out of the kindness of their heart. In fact, this contractor may have something of a reputation for bad work and is having a hard time getting jobs. Or the contractor may be inexperienced and really has no idea how involved the work will be. Hopefully, you'll start looking at contractors before you actually have a lot of homes to start flipping. It's not a good idea to be rushed when looking for a contractor. Call around when you decide to invest in real estate. Speak with a few contractors to get an idea of their experience, prices, and the services they offer. That way, when you get a real emergency on hand, like termite damage, you can just flip through your contacts to a couple of contractors you've already picked out for the job. You should never feel pressured into hiring a contractor for your job. If a contractor or salesperson starts trying to pressure you into signing with them, ask them to back off. Remodeling or rehabbing a house takes a lot of effort, and you want to feel comfortable with the contractor you pick. Ask the contractor to leave if they don't ease up on the high-pressure sales routine. You should also be prepared to end the meeting if the contractor tries to get you locked in by saying that this is a today-only offer or special. This is a common high-pressure tactic designed to get homeowners to hire that contractor now. Even when remodeling, it's best to avoid paying by the hour. You may think you are getting a great deal because the contractor says a project can be done in so many hours, but that's really just an estimate. You'd be surprised how quickly those man-hours add up when the project gets started. If there is anything you take to heart from these tips, it should be the practice of paying a flat rate for the entire project. This also works well in getting a project done quickly. The contractor knows he or she will be getting the same price for completing the job no matter how much time is put into it. It's illegal in most states for contractors to work without a license. You'll certainly avoid a big mess in your project by asking the contractor if she or he is properly licensed to do the job. Don't just take their word for it either. Be sure you get a look at their general contracting license before hiring them. They should have either a photocopy or the real deal on hand. You'll be able to confirm that the contractor is currently licensed with your state's Secretary of State website or office. To learn more about real estate and wholesaling, head to realestateinvestingwholesales.com.